टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फिनोमिनन ऑफ टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. देर आर सो मेनी एग्जाम्पल अराउंड अस वर्किंग अकॉर्डिंग टू फिनोमिनन ऑफ टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन. द फंडामेंटल कंडीशन फॉर दिस फिनोमिनन, लाइट शुड ट्रेवल फ्रॉम डेंसर टू रेरर मीडियम एंड एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस शुड बी ग्रेटर दैन क्रिटिकल एंगल. बट फर्स्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द केसेज. In the first case, when the light travel from denser to rarer medium, denser medium means we have taken the glass, or rarer medium means air. So when the light travel from denser to rarer medium, the angle of refraction will be greater than angle of incidence. In the second case, the angle of incidence is greater than angle of incidence in respect to the first case. Then what we observe, the angle of refraction will be more than previous case, that is R2 is greater than R1. If you further increase the angle of incidence, you find the angle of refraction becomes 90 degree. It coincides with the interface of rarer and denser medium. And if you further increase the angle of incidence, so this refracted ray reflected back in the same medium. So this fourth case, that is when the light travel from denser to rarer medium, provided the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, the light ray reflected back. This phenomenon is termed as total internal reflection. Now what the concept of critical angle? C stand for critical angle in our discussion. So critical angle is the angle of incidence at which the angle of refraction becomes 90 degree, that is the refracted ray coincides with the boundary of two medium. So this is the angle of critical situation or critical angle. Condition already I told, there are two essential conditions. The first, light must travel from denser to rarer medium. The second condition, the angle of incidence should be greater than angle of critical angle. And these two conditions you can see very clearly in the fourth case. The angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, so the light ray which travel from denser to rarer medium reflected back. Now we'll find out what the relation between refractive index and critical angle. So already we know that Snell's law. So light travel from glass to air, so g mu a will be sin I by sin r, because I is the angle of incidence, r is the angle of refraction. At critical angle, that is indirectly the third case, in the third case I is equal to c, that is critical angle, and angle of refraction is 90 degree. So when you put the value of I and r in this equation, g mu a is equal to sin c by sin 90 degree, or sin 91. So we have g mu a is equal to sin c, that is simply the refractive index of air with respect to glass, because the light travels from glass to air. But if you want to know that what is the refractive index of glass with respect to air, you have to use the principle of reversibility. Principle of reversibility say that a mu g is equal to 1 by g mu a. So if you put the value of g mu a in terms of critical angle, that is sin c, then a mu g is equal to 1 by sin c. So very clearly you can say that if you know the critical angle for a particular pair of medium, then you calculate the refractive index of the denser medium with respect to rarer medium using this formula. There are many examples around us. The sparkling of diamond, the mirage, optical fiber, all these are based on the principle of total internal reflection. So here I have taken specifically the optical fiber, because the optical fiber is widely used in so many fields, in communication, in medical, in field of entertainment, widely it is used. What is optical fiber? This is basically very fine, thin wire made of glass material. So the inner part is termed as core. This is made of glass, and the coating part is also made of glass. This is termed as the cladding. Both are made of glass material, but difference is the density of optical density of core region is greater than optical density of cladding. It means core should be denser medium, cladding should be rarer medium. It means the refractive index of core should be greater than refractive index of cladding. And this is the angle, this is the axis of the optical fiber. So very clearly you can say that when any optical signal is incident on the core region, it will transmitted inside, and on this surface, because this is the boundary of the two medium, if the angle of incidence is greater than critical angle, it will be reflected back. And after multiple reflection, this optical signal traverses from one end to other end. In this way, we can transmit the optical signal from one end to other end. So this system is widely used in communication as well as in surgery. Even in our human body, the optical fiber cable connecting our retina with our brain. So whatever image form on the retina, it received by brain through the total internal reflection. And you people have to also search or observe the phenomenon based on total internal reflection around us.